Scientists have been studying hurricanes for decades, but that data has come from measurements higher up in the atmosphere. We traveled to St. Petersburg, Florida to see how new research is literally getting to the bottom of tropical systems.
Our computer models are sensitive to data. The better data coming in, the better information coming out. But 70% of the world is covered by ocean. So where do you get the data over the ocean? That's where these come in, sail drones.
A sail drone is an uncrewed surface vehicle that sails the ocean for months at a time, providing weather and other data to scientists.
It's a completely renewable powered vehicle, so it harnesses wind for propulsion, harnesses solar for power that powers all the onboard sensors and payloads. So that's a suite of oceanographic sensors and a suite of meteorological variables.
We went along for the launch of the seventh sail drone in this year's hurricane mission. This video is from a sail drone in the eye of Hurricane Sam last year and some of the data it sent back.
The data that we're obtaining from sail drone is actually in a particular part of the atmosphere, the very lowest level closest to the ocean, that plays a real critical role in transferring the energy of the ocean into the storm.
Massive storm surge is often the most destructive part of a hurricane, but it's the most difficult to predict. It turns out that hurricane winds aren't the only thing that influence the surge. Hurricane Ian was nearly a Category 5 hurricane, but the storm surge was roughly 15 feet along the Florida coast in October. But Hurricane Katrina, a Cat 3, had a 28-foot surge as it hit Louisiana. NOAA provided this map showing an estimated impact of a 23-foot surge. In the Gulf and East Coast coastal communities, it could inundate 67% of interstates, almost half of all railroad tracks, 29 airports, and virtually all ports in the Gulf Coast area.
The topography of the ocean bottom is a boundary condition for the models that are doing storm surge, because essentially if there's any type of change in the slope or if there are features on the bottom of the ocean, as that storm comes ashore and pushes the water, those features where that slope can really change how the water moves.
But only 35% of the United States' more than 95,000 miles of coastal waters have been mapped with modern methods.
So traditionally, surveys are done with a typical ship that goes out, has a lot of people on board, has a lot of diesel fuel that it's burning. With a sail drone, you don't have the people. You're using the wind for propulsion. And really, that makes us very environmentally friendly and gives us a very long endurance to stay out and reach the farthest parts of the ocean. And that allows us to map down to over 7,000 meters deep, so over 23,000 feet beneath the surface. And the way that works, sonar in general is sound into the ocean. The sound travels, it hits the bottom of the ocean, and then it comes back and we receive it. And that time difference, by taking into account the speed of sound and water, that allows us to determine the depth of the water underneath of the sailboat.
Accurate ocean mapping can help in navigation and managing natural resources, but there are hopes that it could help save lives with better storm surge forecast. I'm meteorologist Joe Calhoun for Forecasting Our Future.